Welcome to Tangling Along with me. We are continuing on tanglepatterns.com and today it is this pattern. Let's open up the book and find a place for this one. So this is kind of a standalone pattern that can kind of grow really, 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 really big. And I am going to use my Micron PM in black for this one. Let me find a place for this one. Let's take this one right here. We could do this one as well. I think I'm gonna do it right here. So the start is kind of a flowery looking thing. So I'm just making kind of a petal here. Another one. And I'm keeping turning my book this way, they will look almost the same, and then it's still not the same. So you have five of these petals here. Then we are going to aura these. And I'm not good at that right now. There we go. And then in between these, I am going to pop one more in there. And I'm going to aura that one straight away. Turn my book. Pop one in right here. All right. Turn my book. Do one more. Alright, and so all the way around. I'm going to go out of my string line here. On this side. There we go. Then I'm going in between these two and doing one more. And again, I am auraing it. And if you have the room for it, do it all the way around. And remember, if you hit a line that you already made with your fine liner, then don't go over it. So I'm doing one here. And I have the room for some of one right here. Let me make this one all the way. So I'm skipping this one over here because it's outside my string line. Again, I'm going in between the leaves here and doing one more. Turning my book, doing it here, and here I am going to mind the line here. So I am going to take my line and just line that up the same over here, like that, because I don't want to go over that line. And again, between these, I have one, and I should have one going out here. So I'm just turning that line in. And then I would have one going up here in between these two here. And again, aura that, and so on. So I wouldn't see that one. Here I would be able to see a tiny bit of it. And the same over here. And I'm gonna make this line like that. And then you can continue on with that until you're happy with the size of it. I'm going to cap my black Micron and take my blue Micron 05 for the last part here, because we are going in between these leaves and making a tinier one in the middle of it. and we're going to color that part in. So a tiny leaf on the inside of the leaves that we already have. And coloring that in, and I think it's pretty with the blue here, but it's also very pretty in the black. Then it's kind of getting into a drama tangle, and I really love the drama tangles. So I know it would be coming up right here, the same over here. And I would actually have one going around this one, so it would be coming out and going up. So I'm going to color that in as well. And over here. So just take your time with this, relax in your hand, and enjoy coloring in these rooms or spaces. It can be really relaxing to do so. I have one up here. Here. And this one. Using my Mono Zero here, my eraser, just trying to show you. And just removing a few lines here from the string that I don't want in there. Now you can use your jelly roll if you want to. You can make the lines here. You can make a line here, or you can make the outer line here. I think I'm gonna do a line here around the blue part. Kind of to make this look a little more intense. And remember, the ink from these jelly rolls needs a little longer to dry, so don't put your hand in them straight away, because then you will smear them around, and we don't want that. I like this. I think that is really pretty. You can go in with your white charcoal if you want to put in some white shading. Oh, let me do that. We can do this middle point right here. I'm just popping in a tiny bit of the white and then using my touch-y-long to soften it out. So I'm going in with my charcoal. Now my graphite, and I am kind of popping in some shadow here where the leaves are coming out underneath the other flower, or the middle flower here. Softening that out with my tortillon. Using the same technique on the next leaves here around everything. I'm not going in over the blue because it leaves this weird shiny spot, and I don't want that one. So I'm just trying to keep it here like that, and then I'm gonna turn my book a tiny bit and do the same over here. Popping graphite in everywhere where it is where the other ones are coming out, so I would have a little run out there, taking my tortillon. And again, soften out these shadows. Like that. And there we go. That is the pattern for today. I think it turned out really, really neat. It is this one right here. I hope you enjoyed that. I had a lot of fun with this one. I really enjoy this pattern. So that is it for today. Thank you for watching. Have an attitude of gratitude.